So I was born in a very lower middle class family, brought up in Katkopa. My father used to work for Nathani Steel Private Limited, where we were provided in the house schooling, for proper schooling. We were sent to a convent school. Fatima High School was the school we were studying. My sister was about 2 years younger to me, and then Anis was born, who is about 9 years younger to me. So we were three children in that house. And because of the salary which my father was getting, he could only provide us with the basics of what is required. That means even to basic tuition fee he was able to pay. Even we had to walk it down to the school, which was almost one station. I mean, this, my school was in Vidya Vihar, and this was in, I was staying in Ghatkopar, so almost 7-8 kilometers I used to walk every day, going and coming, 7 kilometers going, 7 kilometers, because trying to save that extra money on the transportation where dad was going, which can be used as a pocket money. So that's how our journey began. And while I was going to the school, Fatima High School being a convent school, the children who was coming over there, where they were all a little more richer than what my father was, and I used to get about 15 rupees of pocket money. Now with that pocket money, it was impossible for me to live to the standard of the living which my friends were living, and they could afford to go to the canteen, buy a samosa and pick up a chai, and which I was finding it every day difficult, and I had to literally wait. So this was not doing good for me. And how many times you can sit and tell your friends, okay, let me buy me a samosa, you know. So then I told my dad, look, give me some more money. So dad immediately put the breakdown in front of me. So that he says, look, beta, this is what I earn, and majority I'm spending on you, and the which is required for the basics in the house to bring the grocery and all that. I can't afford more than this. So nothing I could do get from dad more than that. So luckily there was some, I would say it was an inborn gift which was in me, which was the business acumen, because my great grandfather was a big businessman. I told my dad, look, I know you can't give me some more extra money. Give me some money to start my business. So I borrowed from him about 1,000 rupees at that particular time. That 1,000 rupees was a lot of money for my dad to give me, that 1,000 rupees.
But I said, how old were you at that time?
About, I would say, 12 years old. Okay. He says, what are you going to do with that? I said, daddy, I will do some business, but I ensure that I will return back your money. So the first thing I did was I went to Masjid Bandar during the school holidays. I bought some books, stationery books, you know, which requires for the next term. Bought some books and told all my friends, you're going to buy these books from different shops. So why not you buy from me, because I'm going to give you at the same price. And that allowed me to make that extra 10-15%, because when you buy from the wholesale market, and the only thing was you had to go to the Masjid Bandar, carry it on your shoulder and bring it and give it to the books. So that helped me for a couple of months. Then came the Diwali season. So Diwali I started selling the firecrackers in the same way. Then came the Rakhi, Raksha Bandhan. So Raksha, Rakhi I sold. But there was a time when lean period was, no other festival was there where I could think of some business. So at that particular time, money was required. That extra 200 rupees mangta hi tha kaisa bhi. I had that 200 rupees which I wanted to have, that so that I could spend that with my friends. So I said, what do in this lean period? So I went and sold doodh, milk, you know. I went, became a milkman, and in the morning 4:30 I used to get up, go to the milk center, pick up the milk and deliver to different houses. And I used to get that 125 rupees salary at the end of the month to sell the, give that milk every month. In the morning while I was driving, riding the bicycle, my bicycle hit a stone and I fell down from that bicycle. In the bargain, the half the milk fell down. That was at 4:35 in the morning and it was pitch dark. So I said, now what do? Well, the milk, 125 dirham salary, 125 rupees salary, or 200 rupees ka to milk gir gaya hai. How do I cover up that? So then I looked around for some water in the dark, and I saw a drum. I saw, hey, this is the water. So I filled in the drum, water from the drum, and put in the that bucket, a jar of the milk, and delivered all the milk to everybody. बाय द टाइम आई वेंट टू गिव माई हिसाब लाइक दिस इज द 200 रुपये का आपसे मिल्क लिया है और 200 का हिसाब देने जाना है, देर आर 7-8 लेडीज कंप्लेनिंग ये कैसा दूध भेज दिया, पूरा पूरा कचरा. सो माई बॉस आस्क्ड मी व्हाट डिड यू डू विद द मिल्क. सो देन आई टोल्ड हिम द एक्चुअल स्टोरी व्हाट हैपेंड. सो आई गॉट अ बिग स्लैप ऑन माई फेस एंड आई सेड टुमारो सो दैट सैलरी विच आई वाज अबाउट टू गेट बिकॉज आई वर्क द होल मंथ दैट ऑल्सो आई लॉस्ट एंड I was thrown out of the job. At the age of 16, my father died. My father expired when he had an accident. He died at the age of 16. Now, what happened was he was earning about 5,000 rupees plus he had some deposits. So for 7,000 rupees were our monthly expenses. So 5,000 rupees he was earning, and at that particular time he had not saved any money. But whatever that money was there, the fixed deposit was there. But otherwise, he had not saved any money where we could use that money. It was our hand-to-mouth we were running at that time. It came like a big bomb to us, like, now what will happen? Luckily, the company which my father worked, he worked there for 20 years. He was a very loyal person in that company. So he worked there for 20 years and immediately the bosses called me and said, Rizwan, what are you going to do? So I said, Uncle, I don't know what I'm going to do, but I'm in a big mess over here and I have to continue my studies and I might have to manage my house and I don't know what to do. So they gave me a job in that company, which was about 2,000 rupees. They gave me a job. There was this some money we got from the gratuity. You know, we have in India, we have this gratuity where, but that also, they put that money in the fixed deposit. So the 3,000 I could get from the gratuity, and but still there was a shortage of 2,000 rupees now to manage the house. 7 to 10 I used to go to the college, 10, 11 o'clock I used to go to my office over there, 11 to 6 I was in Nathani, but to cover that 2,000 rupees, I started a small business over there near my house where we used to make the box files. So 7 o'clock I used to go to the factory, whatever the box files were ready over there, pick up, go to the Masjid Banda. So yeah. The life was like starting in the morning at 7 and going home by 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. While all my friends were enjoying and partying and picnic, I was basically trying to complete the. So in the bargain, I wrote to my uncle in Kuwait. And I told him, look, I need to come to Kuwait because I am not able to manage over here and you are the only savior for me who can help me to bring over here. And I don't need any money from you, just give me a job. So at that time he wrote me a letter that, Rizwan, sorry I can't give you a job because you are only 16 and a half years old. Because 16 my dad expired, half year I was trying to do some jugglery but I was not working out. So 16 and a half, he wrote to me that you are only 16 and a half and until you become 18, I can't give you a job. So I really thought that, you know, this is an uncle who wants to also, most of the, you know, relatives when you are in problem, they don't try to help you out. And this is one of them and trying to just give me an excuse that he cannot bring me. I said, okay, uncle, what to do? Life continued, same thing, getting up at 6 o'clock, going to the just 7 o'clock, coming back home, 11, sleeping at 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock for 1.5 years. But somehow managing, not luckily I didn't have to ask any money from anybody, the life was going on. On my 18th birthday, I got a letter from my uncle. At that time, you know, they were telling you that that thing was not there, emails and all that were not there. So I got a letter delivered, postal delivered exactly on my 18th birthday. And he said, Rizwan, if you want to come to Kuwait, you return to me and I can give you a job and your salary will be 150 dinars, which was 18,000 rupees. So I said, wow, so this is like 18,000 rupees from a 7,000, I'm working from 9 to 6, I had to work and 18,000 rupees, immediately I accepted the offer. I told my mama that I need to go, please let me go because this will change my whole career. So next month I was in Kuwait and touched with this uncle of mine. He taught me how to make 2 plus 2, 5. Because he was a businessman and he was like, he really taught me the whole business. This is the wood business, what is LC, what is negotiation, what is the discrepancy, how to negotiate an LC and everything what is required in the business terms. He kept me in his house for 6 months and I studied everything, learned everything from him. And things were going very perfect for me. perfect means extraordinary perfect. I started with 150 dinar salary, and by the time in the 8 year span, I started earning about 1500 dinar salary with the virtue of commission, because that job which was given to me was salary plus commission. So I was the highest seller in that company, because again I'm telling you, the sales acumen which God had gifted to me, it was easier for me to sell material and come. Got myself married, got my sister married, got a beautiful house in Bandra next to Shah Rukh Khan's house. So everything perfectly moving as you want, as a normal, because I was not even BCom, a graduate. And all of a sudden, Saddam Hussein comes in again. Saddam Hussein comes in, destroys the whole Kuwait, invade the Kuwait, and we are back to square one, because whatever the money which I made during that time went into two marriages in the house, and buying the house and whatever required the basics. So there was hardly any money which I could I had in my pocket, and we all had to run away from Kuwait. During that period also, because it was a lull period, I made a little bit of money over there. Now again, even after that 8 years of fantastic journey, we sold again oil on the roads. We sold because, and we also sent telegrams to, we helped people to send telegrams to Baghdad. We went to Basra and driving from Kuwait to Basra, sending the telegrams, and made some money. And then we went to Mumbai. Mumbai, we had what I had in my pocket, almost 70,000-80,000 rupees. That was the only money which we had in. And my house was there in Bandra, and I didn't have a car. Unfortunately, I had not bought the car. So there was a small Honda, Kinetic Honda, which I had in with me. So driving a Pajero in Kuwait, and again back to a Kinetic Honda in Mumbai in the traffic. So started selling something or the other there. Started working for one of my friend, and started selling, because selling was the only thing which I knew to do. I'm making about 20-25,000 rupees, managing the house. I wrote to my friend in Dubai that I want to come to Dubai and if you can help me. And that's how I came to Dubai. Started working with him for 1 year, and within 1 year I decided, look, I'm going to start my business. Because in that 1 year what happened was, Kuwait opened out. Now, because I was in Kuwait for the last 8 years, I knew all the Kuwaitis, all the local people over there. So Saddam Hussein had stolen everything. Saddam Hussein's army had stolen everything from Kuwait and taken back to Iraq. So the Kuwaitis got again their country back, at that time there was nothing in that country. So, and the port was broken, the airport was broken, everything was not there. And they required by road lot of material, and Dubai was the contact where they could get all this, you know, the refrigerators and cookers and whatever they would require, the building material, what was required was going from Dubai. And because of the connections which I had in Kuwait for the last 8 years, I was in the right place sitting at the right day. So in that 1 year, I made about 100,000 dirhams as a commission. After 1 year, I said 100,000 dirhams to ban gaya. Abhi now I want to do my own business. So I told my wife that, look, I think I should do my own business. So there's hard enough time, because every time I have proved that I can do, I fall and I have proved that I can come back again. So let me try this. And with that 100,000 dirhams, I said, if I don't make sense, if I'm not able to succeed, anybody will give me a job of 5,000, 10,000 dirhams for sure with the experience which I have. And that's how we took the risk and we started the company. But the company which we started was doing only brokerage. Brokerage means somebody wants to buy building material and somebody wants to sell building material. Put them together and earn that 1%, 2% commission. So that's how this company Danube was formed. Now in the brokerage business, luckily I got a good break. Because initially what happened was, when I started going to the companies to sell on brokerage, all these big sharks who are sitting over here selling the building material, and I said, I am from Kuwait and I have a full knowledge of building material and I can offer you good prices and you should buy from me this material. And they used to look at me and laugh. I said, you have come from Kuwait and we are in Dubai, much seasoned people than what you Kuwait people buy from, and I don't think I can we can buy from you. But one agency which I had in Kuwait, that agency I was able to bring it back to this market, and that was a very good product. It's what galvanized corrugated sheets from Japan. Now that product was in demand here, and with that product I went and sold everybody that galvanized corrugated sheet. That's how I got an entry to all these big sharks over here who are sitting over here. And once you get an entry, then you sell one product, you sell the another product, and you somehow manage. That indenting business was doing good, a brokerage business was doing good. It was making me about 40-50,000 dirhams a month, which was good enough for me to survive. But if I had to go further, I had to do trading. Now for the trading, did not have any money with me, because you require a lot of money. But the only thing in that last 10 years, 8 years in Kuwait and 2 years in Dubai, what I had earned is the credibility with my suppliers, where I used to guide them. This is the, like, if they sell there, they want to sell at X price, and I used to say, no, we can sell at X1, X plus 1, because the market can pay that X plus 1. That credibility which we had developed, I told the suppliers that, look, I want to do some trading, but I don't have the money. Give me this $25,000, $50,000 of worth of material. I will bring it in my name, sell it, and then give you back the money. Because when you work as a broker, you get that 1% or 2% commission. But when you work as a trader, you get that 10%, 15% commission. So you started making that extra money. Then I went to the banks, approached them for loans. Bank gave me a small loan. And slowly, slowly, calculative risk I kept on taking year after year. I think UAE has contributed a lot to my growth because of the business-friendly environment which we have over here, where you can start your business, do your business, without any bureaucracy, without any gundagardi, what you say, that in India we have this transfer market. Yeah, absolutely. So you can do your business. You buy for one dirham, you sell for one dirham 10 paisa, five paisa is your profit and 5 paisa is your expenses. The simple business you have, as long as you're working hard, you know what you're doing, you can expand. So that helped me a lot, and the calculative risk which we took, that made me. But asking to your question, yes, UAE definitely helped me a lot. And what important was, we took a place in Jabal Ali, and that spurred the highest growth, because we came to Jabal Ali, and Jabal Ali really supported us in whatever we required, and gave us the right space on the main road, and gave me that beginning which was required to make it to a higher level.